on a new camera, I decided to buy one cheap because, you know, $40 is not too bad. And all it did, probably near, I don't know why it was so expensive, but, you know, I got the, you know, Walmart brand, including, if you know, Jaguars, comment, like, subscribe below, because I like making videos like this. Apparently, my company is going to start releasing drive-in theaters for the most of the U.S., like, certain amount of stores, you know, in locations, you know, so they don't have to spread this virus that's going around like crazy, and, I had to get ready, and, this is basically the Walmart brand, you can tell, and, works pretty good, I guess. It's one of the most best reviewed. Then I got this to go with a camera that is, waterproof, and, I gotta be using this. I mean, I don't go underwater for a reason. I mean, there's, I don't do it, so, like, you just snap it back in. It's hard to understand that first. Like, do it like a minute or so, how to undo that, undo this from the camera, and by now, I think this camera can only do up to 32 gigs of storage, so, like, I have to buy another storage or empty this one printer or the built-in adapter, which I have one of my Apple printer. I can stick that thing in there and then stick it in the back of the Mac and get the footage. So, yeah, going camping, I had to get ready, I had to buy, you know, a certain amount of things like shirts, not shirts, but swimming trunks. Luckily, they had a bunch left. They were, you know, pretty cheap, $10. And then, also I had to get, like, coffee and then, some sodas, some snacks, bread, things like that, and, tar catchers, so I had, like, two of those, you know, special ones I like buying at my store where you can get a coupon for, like, outreach. Every time you buy one of those $3 ones, you get, like, a dollar coupon off, so I used two of those for those two, like, color catchers that are small, and you just put them in your washer so that the colors don't get mixed up in the washer, so you don't have to run clothes with different kinds of colors, we just have their own color only, and that's why I want to keep it light as. So, yeah, there's been more cases in my area. Not as bad as Florida. Florida's been having over 10,000 over the weekend, and they're not wearing masks now. I think yeah, they're wearing masks wherever you go right now in my area, including Walmart and anywhere, basically. So I got to wash some clothes, take out the trash, which I know is a sun or smell, of course, but, you know, I will probably take it out eventually. Yeah, if you understand, go ahead and subscribe down like below. I have a limited work schedule, like I can only upload so much at a time, you know, and with the hours I work, and then, you know, having family over here, I can't really do, and because my sister was in here gaming on my Xbox One until like 2 o'clock in the morning or 3, or 1 o'clock in the morning, she's, you know, sleeps in until like noon, and I just go to bed around 9, I mean 8 o'clock, 7. I had to sleep in this room because it was so hot in my room because it's July. It's the hottest month of this location. So it doesn't feel too bad in there right now from an hour ago, but it will get hotter. There's a heat index warning today as well. About the same. So I might go Taco Bell or I may order Pizza Hut. I might just order pizza without the cheese because I just had horrible drainage. Mucus production that I had an allergy to dairy products in the past, and it's apparently a little bit active but not really bad enough where it could really affect me enough to get my lungs to actually get inflamed with this mucus and leading to an infection. It's just not worth eating dairy, and since I've been doing that since February, my infections have gone down a lot for lung infections, and I haven't had one since February, so it's been quite a bit of months sticking away, staying away from the dairy. Every now and then I'll have some, but not as consistent as I was last year. Because I was ordering pizza after pizza with a lot of cheese, and I just decided I don't need this. I'm telling you, I'm telling you to stay away from the dairy. It's causing issues, and it worked fine after that. Gluten, I had to go away from as well because I might have some stomach trouble. Every now and then I have good stomach. I had to go two times. Sometimes I had so much trouble I had to go to the bathroom take a while to get rid of wherever I had in my stomach. And yeah, if you go straight down, you know, you gotta get that feeling, you gotta really go after eating so very little. I mean, I'll eat like a soup or during lunch, and no matter how it kicked me in the rear end, and have to go. It's like, and I might have irritable bowel, or I might have like losing control. And yeah, I don't help either, but there's one I'm sure. Because apparently there's trouble, you know. Every now and then it gets better, improves. But I try to stay to soup sometimes, and I was high on sodium, but you know, you don't have one can of that, and you're fine. You know, like, soup can have one of the microwavable versions of it. That's the vegetable beef I like. And I usually eat, like eating soup, and I'm going to have surgery in the next month or so, so I might be off a while. I don't know. I'm going to try to. I might be at my parents' house because who knows what. With the hemophilia and the bleeding disease, and then having this disease, since you're like 10 months old, and test positive for it. When you are missing a protein in your blood, where your blood doesn't physically clot. So it's hard to know when you're having bleed or not. It's just going to be wise to know when you are. The treated guys can get uncontrollable, and I've been down that road. And I've been lucky enough to keep my right eye vision, because I did have a bleed in my right eye face over here a couple years ago. I think it was 1 year ago in January, and we got in the nick of time to actually treat it and keep it from going anywhere else, and it eventually resolved. So, yeah, that's one of the scariest, worst bleeds I ever had in my life. I can tell you one thing, besides the left leg bleed, which I'm surprised that leg is still the best leg. The right one's a little messed up. When I went to the doctor last week, you know, on Thursday or like Friday, I have a bad right leg. Apparently, the leg cannot move in a certain direction like it used to. So it's got limited motion, and they did put me on muscle relaxer to kind of ease the time usage, and that's been helping quite a bit. There's still pain, but not as bad as it was before. It was horrible. I mean, I could really not walk. With that, some sciatic nerve, and then I decided I needed to replace, I needed to get my shoes that put the arch supports in them. I had to tear one layer out, the bone layer that it came with, and then put the arch support in. They didn't tear out that front, that bottom thing where you have the, your feet are at, below that, a little bit, that cushioning spot. And I got arch supports that got cushioning in them, and they support me in a way where I do have bad feet, so that could have interfered with my hip. I'm feeling like it definitely was causing trouble with my hip. It's definitely improving since over a week, about a week ago, and thankfully it's working. They're saying they had to replace it every 3 months. They usually don't replace it until like a year or more, but I'm going to probably try to stay up 2 or 3 months at a time to replace the supports. As they're, wherever shoe I wear, I'll wear it. I have arch support in them regardless if my feet are so bad. My right foot arch is collapsed, the left one's good. So, I had this trouble since I was like fourth grade, about 11, 10 years old. And there's nothing you do about it. I could have surgery, but then it's like, who wants to deal with factor and then have a bleed? And, I don't know, it's even worse than having the surgery. I mean, I just wear shoes that are good supports. And I just don't like surgery, but I still have to go through it. But whatever. So, thanks for watching. See ya.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe and like below. I seem like I edited this in an iMovie to make it a little bit more better. And I forgot I messed up on saying about the Walmart movie theater. It's going to be through August to October. And there's going to be certain locations like 160 or wherever locations where they'll put up the big screen and they'll have snacks and all this. And it's all over the web right now for a couple of weeks ago. And hopefully it goes around. Hopefully we get one at my store, but I can't guarantee it. But, you know, it's a driving movie theater. They don't want to help. Because movie theaters can't be open during this pandemic and this COVID thing that's apparently mutated already. Either it's going to be more harmful or more spreading, which it is more spreading. Or less harmful. I don't know with one, but we're still vaccine might be still months away until the end of the year, but thanks for watching. See ya.